Was it okay or was it still too early going in?
No, it's fine. I can say I'm already recording.
Okay, somebody's knocking at the door.
Yeah? Yes! Okie dokie.
Let's go.
Thank you. cool.
So this is Kathy Hein and my name is Sabine Kugel. And we are in the middle of our work, so this is a work in progress showing. It's not a done performance yet. So we have worked on new material, new ideas with the screens of eyes, and we are going to do now maybe a 10 to 15 minutes performance, and then we are open for feedback and a talk, and then afterwards we might play another track for you that we already recorded because we're planning to do a DVD release. And yeah, so let's start.
Yeah, this is just twitched itself off on it, so okay. I get back on, yeah. No, it's just they're all battery powered, so I've been recharging them and that's not switching on, but they will be inset. Do you want to talk about anything or something?
Yeah, so Kathy and I actually, we've been working together since quite
maybe
two years. We met very spontaneously on a festival in Sweden. Mats Lindström brought us together. And then since then we meet together, and last year in August we had a 1 week residency here and made our collaboration really like not just being on stage and trying to put something together, so we really dived into something. And we are really happy to be here again, so thank you. And yeah, I hope this is working out. No? Wait. Oh, yeah, it's not working.
Oh, yeah, it's not working.
So last time when we were here, we worked basically with water and glass and prospects, and this time Kathy came up with the idea to invent the screen of ice.
Ice screen. Which you might serve later.
This is the prototype. We are planning to do it bigger actually, and maybe several of them. Yeah.
Oh, I'll just get it.
Okay.
So, well, it's really difficult to tell. I might just like add it like that. And yeah, it's just really, really dark. Yeah, it's just really. It's probably just me not. Yeah, it'll be fine. Sorry about that. I'm well in control of my technical things. So, yeah, thanks for being here. Thank you.
Americans use screens or any material you just recorded during the last couple of days. Some older stuff, but most of it is quite new actually. Any questions?
Does screen, did you do it like the candles, dipping it in water?
Actually, I did them in like a stack. So, I mean, the wooden one was the first attempt, and the aluminium one is the second. And I think I'd quite like to go for it, try and make it work without having a frame around it. So it's actually a sheet of ice. The wooden one's got a sheet of perspex in it, so the ice is, water's got something to grip onto, so it doesn't suddenly fall out. And then the aluminium one's got strands of wire.
Uh-huh.
But I think the wire works quite well, and it could work just as some kind of thin mesh, so that it's just hanging. And I think we'd like to. We mean this came from us wanting to do a performance that had a kind of quality of installation, or could be an installation as well. So maybe when we're in a space, we're kind of in the centre, and it's surround sounds, all the sounds around you, and then we have stuff at two points. So the audience can kind of look through and look out, and this whole balance of wanting to watch, you know, the live performer and also watch, have some visuals,
mm-hmm.
without it being a kind of stage and screen. The way I did the ice was just kind of put tin foil underneath it and then stacked it in the freezer. And they're that size because that's the size of Taco's freezer. Thank you very much for the freezer.
I thought maybe it was like way of thin paper, and then you dip it in water, freeze it, dip
that
it in
might
water, freeze it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I think
very something like that.
But it might be nice to do layers. I don't know. I mean, I think it's worth, you know, it needs quite a lot more experiment. It takes a long time to freeze. And the other idea we had was for the performance to last as long as the screens take to melt.
Mm.
Which on the first time was like 4 hours. but it does. It is quite interesting when it does start to disappear from the top, and you just get these little bits. And I think there's something to do with what you're doing with the layering of the sound, and it kind of can be very full as the ice disappears.
Maybe do the screens a little bit thinner,
yeah,
so that they melt
in about an hour.
Or we can play in Brazil or something.
So, yeah, the sort of durational element of something disappearing while we're playing is quite attractive.
Well, maybe a warm lamp on it,
yeah.
It melts really quickly.
Yeah.
And then you have always the lamp.
Yeah.
Well, the projector, unfortunately, the LED projectors, they don't get very hot.
No.
And there's another idea we haven't tried out yet, somehow to create steam and project on the steam as well, so that we have all this water states.
Because I think we were talking about a while ago when we started talking about doing installation, and also the sounds that Sabina recorded, there was some definitely ice and water, and then underwater sounds, and bird sounds, which is kind of like air. We were thinking about water in different states, so we've got ice, water, and we wanted to have steam as well. And then also this idea of using a sheet of glass that's kind of reflective, and it's glass is like a fluid in its molecular structure, so playing around with these kind of contrasts and opposites and different states. But I mean, it's really, because we're behind it, it does look really different from your point of view, and every time we do the ice it's different, so I don't know how well imagery came out on the ice.
I did see the birds and the deposit. A swan or something trying to
preening.
Fly.
Oh yeah,
and
crane.
So, yeah, it's pretty clear to me.
Oh good. Looks kind of blurry from behind.
It feels like at the moment, because they're still experimenting with different shapes and all that, that the structure or the frame is really prominent in the space, and it seems like that's going to be another challenge to try to make that sort of invisible or...
Well, to try and lose the frame.
Yeah. Also including like the...
All this... All our stands.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of... functional and makeshift, but also, I mean, I quite like these clamps as well, but then maybe it doesn't.
Well, I guess it's
bad.
Yeah, I guess it's up to your.
Yeah, but I know what
well.
You're saying. It's kind of there's a lot of kit, despite bringing miniature projectors that are this big.
Yeah.
If only things would hover in the air.
Mm.
But yeah.
Nylon thread or something.
Sorry.
Maybe nylon thread.
Yeah.
Or something like that.
And how much do those projectors cost?
Well, they vary, but I mean, I've borrowed these actually off a friend and now made a piece of them, so I can't have to go. But they range from. They only kind of came on the market like a couple of years ago, and they started off about £300, which is
okay.
Pretty pricey considering how bright they get. But now those ones are about £90,
really,
and there's better ones now that are kind of £200.
Mm.
But the ones that have just come out about. I mean, they're 10 lumens. Kind of, but you know, for the small intense
yeah.
space, it works well. But the new ones are 20 lumens, and so I'm sure it's the kind of technology that's. As soon as I suppose the demand for them gets more, and people think that's really really useful, when they get good enough, they'll probably
yeah.
get a lot cheaper.
Nice.
Yeah. But they are really nice, and it's so refreshing not to have you know a great big clunky, huge. Thing with a fan that for projecting.
They are quite loud as well.
They are a little bit. yeah.
So I guess the challenge of this project is.
There's many.
many, but the main subject is the question about the genre. Is it a concept? Or is it an installation? Or is it both? Right? And
you mean how do we
how do you manage to actually make this crossbreeding happen, so to speak?
Well, I think it's really nice that it could be one or the other and you don't know. I mean, we were wondering, because obviously we want to try and get some gigs, what to call it, and there's performance installation. We wanted to, we didn't, what did we come up with?
You came up with choreography, which is
oh,
really
yeah.
funny.
Oh. Using the word choreography because it's like a completely different discipline.
But I think this is
but
important
yeah.
For
yeah,
for organizers to
yeah,
know
yeah.
what is what
installative concert, audiovisual concert, or I don't know.
But then we also thought maybe using the word sculptural,
which I like.
Sculptural
word. Music. I don't know. We haven't found the name yet.
Maybe an installation performance is the easiest to grasp because people do call things that, but usually that's something that's kind of long duration. Constellation, yeah.
Concert installation.
Yeah.
It would be also, like, the idea is also maybe that we do a live performance and then we leave it and it stays itself as an installation, actually.
Because actually, we had these thoughts about. You know, doing a concert and leaving traces of that performance within the installation, so there would be, because every time you're performing, I mean, there's some recordings, but you're also live sampling, so, you know, there's all these sounds that get used in the concert that are generated in that time that, you know, could be remaining within the installation. The other thing is, we've got hydrophones in with the dribbling water and the dripping water, and then Sabine's got a patch that just switches them randomly on and off, so there is a kind of state that is kind of existing in using. You can come in.
You can come in.
So there's something, there's a layer going on that's kind of got on and off randomness. So, you know, I don't know whether that's more installation or it could be something that's incorporated into how we use the traces of sound.
I think the more you go towards the idea of the installation, the more you have to be careful about how you present yourself on stage, because you're getting in. It's like a competition. In, I mean, if you want it or not. It's a sort of a composition between eye and music, and between performance and the installation aspect. So I think it's very important for the performers to be almost directed or by light, because this is also like a light. Well, it's an installation, but also since these the visuals you can see are moving, so it's some sort of direction involved. And the same should be with the performer.
Yeah,
I'm not sure if you're also consider yourself a performer. So
well,
that
not
should
in
be
the context of. Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
No, that should be just an aspect of.
I think you know it's important. I think you know the lighting isn't ideal for Sabine. You know but I think you know definitely this is this idea that when we do construct it, it is a bit more that is all considered. Yeah, and I think the way Sabine's lit because she's playing the flute and she's moving, and I think that's a definite performance. I'm, you know, kind of triggering these things, and so I'm less. I think visually, my body and what I'm doing is to be seen. But we had this other thought about creating, because we also tried putting LEDs into ice cubes, and they have this similar kind of glowing quality, the way light kind of refracts in ice. And you know, another idea was to maybe make a kind of a screen of those, but just using sort of light and shade. And that could be something that, because it's just using light, it's not moving image, but we could work with how they kind of illuminate and change. I mean, that could be something that's in another part that actually also acts as a light for the performer. I mean,
yeah, that's a good idea, I think.
And that would sort of
melt
as well.
Different spots, so to speak.
Yeah. Thanks. So I think it needs to be really well, yeah, like you say, it's almost like a stage set, but as well as being the whole thing, yeah.
And at the beginning you were saying that you can imagine a situation where people, is a surround sound situation, and people are wandering through the installation, or sort of, no?
No, maybe just sort of,
I don't know, yeah, I don't know, because sometimes it's loud and it's okay, but sometimes it becomes very delicate and very quiet, so maybe more seating.
I mean, maybe the idea doesn't work because you're facing a certain way and people are behind you.
Yeah.
A lazy Susan.
What's a lazy Susan?
It's, you know, in restaurants when they have something that spins in the middle.
Ah, right. That's a funny name.
Good name.
I like it.
Need a lighting designer.
Did you try the plastic bags with to make screens? You have those square plastic bags with those sort of zipper.
Yeah, that's a
maybe
good
that's
idea.
That's a way to want to try, and then you just cut away the plastic bag or something.
Oh, we should have popped down earlier in the week. That's a really good idea.
To know which one I'm in.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
The white zippery thing.
Because you do those ice cube bags, don't you?
Exactly, that I was thinking about those.
Oh, that's a brilliant idea. Because I can even put wire thread in there first. Oh, that's really good.
Esther,
yay! Always practical.
Yeah, well, this is it. We need practical solutions.
The good thing about this is because Kathy came by ferry boat, not to carry, because she had
I wanted to bring a sheet of glass and some smaller sheets.
It was really heavy, everything. And with this screen now, it's really great. I mean,
if I use plastic bag,
yeah, then it's just like you can fly all over the world.
Yeah. I mean, do you want to just play that other piece?
Yeah.
We have this other thing that we've been working on, and we sort of want to put together a DVD that's audio, you know, sound vision. We did one piece in December, and we've just been exchanging material during this week and trying out some new parts. But we've got one that's like 3 minutes that we could play. Anything, I'm going to have to project it onto the glass, so it's not really intended for that purpose.
So you can project on the ice?
Yeah, I can, but still, it's Dionysus. be a little bit better at recognizing input. Yeah, so I mean, you know, that was our little first track.